No, I don't want to fight. I don't want to fight. I like how I'm just messing with the freaking... Ow! I like how I'm just messing with the gravestones. That was actually really easy. Oh, well, that's just brutal. He's all over the place. Actually really quick. I actually thought, you know, this being the final boss, it would take a little bit, you know? That was a little disappointing. I mean, as soon as you fight the Death Eaters, as soon as you're done with the Death Eaters, you fight Voldemort, which all you have to do is press X. That was a little disappointing. Whoa! Whoa! Keep it PG-13. Oh, wow. He just got bitch slapped. Huh? Unicorn shit. That, my friends, is the end of years 1 through 4 of Harry Potter in Lego form. Alright, so now that this part of the Harry Potter story is finally finished, I can give my quick thoughts on the game. And I gotta say, it was fun. It's a typical Lego. Gameplay-wise, it's always going to be the same. But I like what they did with the magic spells. You know, you have a whole bunch of magic spells you can choose from. The only thing I don't like is how, you know, depending on which spell you use, or I'm gonna call it the red circle. You know, you have like 5 different spells for that one. You probably have more than that, but you can't choose which one you want to use. It's all about a matter of luck if you want the one you want. Because it just keeps going, always switching. You never, like, if you want to free somebody, you know, you can't, you have to press it at the right time to even be able to do it. I don't like that. But I will say that even though I don't like how they did that, I still liked how they handled magic. Besides that little bit. I will say the beginning and the end of this game, it feels like they rushed it very quickly. Because, you know, the first part, you know, it feels like they rushed it very, very horribly. Well, not horribly, but, you know, it feels like they just wanted to get right to the gameplay. And, you know, I feel like they could have added some levels, you know, like Harry in the museum, you know, where, you know, I feel like they could have added at least one level to that. You know, during that part, that way you can, you know, kind of get some humor with the Dursleys. You know, you still had that humor with them, but, you know, I feel like they could have added a level like that. And then the ending, it just feels like they rushed right through it. And especially that final boss fight. And even though the boss fights in LEGO games are okay at best, you know, they're nothing special, I really think that every LEGO game, the boss battles are just... eh, you know, they're there, they're just, they're slightly little bits tougher, than, you know, regular enemies, but they're there. You know, there's nothing much to it. But come on, Voldemort, this is that was the final boss. You know, you would think it would be at least a little tougher to get through it than the other boss fights you had. You would expect it. But all you really had to do was hit each Death Eater and then hit X repeatedly. That's it. That was nothing special. But I will say, I do think they handled, you know, the first four Harry Potter, I'll say movies, because, you know, this is following the movies more than the books. I will say, I think they did a good job at following the movies. Though I will say, I kind of wish they... It feels kind of... There are certain parts where it felt like they kind of grabbed one thing and placed it in the other, and, you know, they skip certain scenes, but, you know, it is what it is. So, my score, you know, I'm going to base it off of how it is, you know, a Lego game and all that. Nine or 9.5 out of 10. Because, like I said, you know, me personally, I'm not that big of a Lego fan, but I still have fun with it. It's just, I can get a little bored with it. Like, you know, somewhere in the middle of Prisoner of Azkaban, I was getting a little bored with this game. Even though I'm a huge Harry Potter fan, I was just like, I kind of wanted to play something else more action-y. You know, like Dante's Inferno, which I kind of been postponing on recording. But, you know, that's just me. You know, it's still a fun game. It's just, I'm not that big of a Lego fan. But for someone like me, you know, this game I'll have fun with. I'll enjoy the little comedic humor involving my favorite Harry Potter stories. It's just, you know, it's just not that type of game I would actually go out and buy. Unless, you know, it's Lego Marvel or Lego Batman 2. Because I like the comedic humor, but I much prefer voices that tell the story. And, you know, that's a little biased by me because it's, you know, I'm sort of basing my opinion off of that. But, you know, it's just, I get a little bored with these games. And that's just my opinion, you know. But I still give it a pretty high score. I gave it a really high score. So, 9 or 9.5 out of 10. So, next time, I will see you guys when we finish up Harry Potter Lego with the years 5 through 7.